Governor Dayton blasts the chief of police in Minneapolis, calling her actions extremely inappropriate and saying that he wasn't consulted before she made a big policy change. Last night, we were the first to report that the state will handle future high-profile internal investigations at MPD. But the governor says right now, that deal's off. Our Steve Tellier has been working the story the past 2 days. He joins us now with new details. Steve.
Ellen, we spoke with a Minneapolis Police Department spokesperson late this evening. She says the chief is, quote, perplexed by the governor's reaction to this and insists MPD and State Bureau of Criminal Apprehension officials have been meeting on this issue since the summer. They say they just finalized this arrangement at a joint meeting on Friday. It was late this afternoon when the governor's office plainly and forcefully told us there is no agreement.
This is all about public trust. This is about perception and public trust.
That was Minneapolis Police Chief Janae Harto on Wednesday morning before the governor's statement explaining the reasoning for her new policy. It was announced in an internal memo on Monday and effectively outsources the department's most serious internal investigations to the state.
There was concern by members of this council and members of the community with why Minneapolis continues to investigate their own and critical incidents.
Harto says the BCA will now handle investigations of Minneapolis officers who seriously injure or kill suspects, like the Terrence Franklin case and other high-profile cases of officer conduct. But late Wednesday afternoon, Governor Dayton's office gave us this statement, quote, the Minneapolis Chief of Police unilaterally announced this proposed arrangement without first notifying the Commissioner of Public Safety, Governor Dayton, or the Governor's Chief of Staff, a course of action that the governor considers extremely inappropriate. Given this turn of events, and until all parties reach agreement on this matter, the arrangement announced by the Minneapolis Chief of Police is inoperative.
BCA is a busy organization. Yeah, they're doing a lot of stuff.
Former Minneapolis police officer Michael Quinn says the problem could be one of limited resources. How much time are state investigators able or willing to devote to potentially lengthy, costly Minneapolis cases?
My concern would be, is the BCA going to have a lot of time to do this?
We have tried to get more details on how this arrangement would work in practice and find out who would foot the bill, but no one seems to know. And the BCA hasn't responded to our request for comment or information on this issue for the past 32 hours. We should mention the Minneapolis Police Officers Union does not support this arrangement, but also has not returned our calls for comment. Ellen?
Thanks, Steve. And we also checked in with the St. Paul Police Department, and we're told all internal officer conduct cases are handled by the department itself. However, the BCA does handle internal investigations for many other law enforcement agencies across Minnesota.
There is